A huge thanks to Brian for sponsoring this video. Good morning, fellow mathematicians. Welcome back to another video. My name is Snack. He's your host today. He wants to do some snack-o-matics today, snack-o-mathematics. And we're going to do something today that I started back before the hacking. It's kind of a little mini series here on this channel. Nothing too serious, just some math for fun, you could say, or whatsoever. It's mathematics gone wrong, done right. Before the hacking, I did this with this weird wrong fraction addition. Okay, a over b plus c over d is a plus c over b plus d. Okay, maybe you can remember. And I would like to do this with a lot of rules that you could come up with. And today we would like to deal with something, okay, with solutions to x to the y equals y to the x, okay? It's like wrongly interchanging those exponents with the base, okay? It's a wrong rule you could do in mathematics, but it actually has some solutions apart from the trivial solutions 1 and 1, okay? This pair of solutions. And we are basically going to dive right in. Also, make sure to check out the new channel, Flammable W. I'm going to post there regularly German and English mathematics videos, basic mathematics. So check it out. If you watch the videos, watch them to their full extent, because it just helps keep the channel alive, favor the channels by the YouTube algorithm, blah, blah, blah. And now we are going to deal with this problem. Like I said before, there are actually trivial solutions. When x is equal to y, that's a trivial solution. Also, in some way, yeah, 0 to the 0th power, it really depends. Okay, if they both approach the limit, x approaches 0 and y approaches 0 simultaneously, then this works out. Okay, those are trivial solutions, and also some other. But there's actually a set of non-trivial solutions that we are going to cover today, which involves making use of the Lambert W function, okay? If you were to type this into Wolfram Alpha, it's going to spit you something out with some weird W function. This Lambert W function, links for reference will be down there at the top of the description. At first, I would like to solve a little bit for one variable right now. We are going to, I really don't care, we are going to take the y-fu root on both sides, okay? 1 over y-fu power. We are going to end up with x being equal to y to the x over y. And now I would like to rewrite this right-hand side here. We want to turn this into some kind of exponential function. If you have a to the b, that's the same as e to the ln of a to the b. You can bring the b to the front to turn this into e to the b times ln of a. Same spiel here. We are going to turn this into e to the natural log of y to the x over y. And now we can bring this x over y, this exponent, to the front, turning this into e to the x over y times logarithmus naturalis of y. Okay? Now we have rewritten this a tiny little bit. But how can we proceed from this point onwards? Now here comes some information about the Lambert W function. The Lambert W function is defined as the inverse function of the following function, f of x, being defined as x times e to the x. And if you apply an inverse function, if it's locally invertible, for example, to this function on a certain interval, okay, the Lambert W function actually has two branches, so it's not a function in normal case, it's more like a mapping. But if you apply the Lambert W function on both sides, you are able to extract the argument x from here. Meaning, if we were to apply Lambert W function to f, we are going to end up with x in itself. But on the other hand, this is the same as applying the Lambert W function to this side. So Lambert W of x times e to the x. We are going to do the same thing here, okay? We would like to apply the Lambert W function on both sides such that we can extract either x or y from this equation that we have here. But we need to do some more manipulations at the moment, simply because our x in front of the e to the x is missing at the moment. E to the x in our case right now is, e to the x over y times the logarithm of y. Now, if we just were to multiply this exponent on both sides, okay, it's it shouldn't be equal to zero, otherwise we would run into problems. Then we would have a certain situation, namely, I'm going to write it out. If we just were to multiply both sides by the exponent, we would end up with x squared over y times the logarithm of y being equal to x over y times the logarithm of y times e to the x over y times the logarithm of y. Thing is, we can't really solve for one variable here at the moment. If we were to apply the Lambert W function on both sides right now, then, well, this Lambert W function is dependent on x and y yet again, which really wouldn't be the point of solving for one variable. But we can do a little trick, which works really well with exponents. So we are going to scratch this idea, we are going to get rid of it. What we are going to do is we are going to invert both sides under the condition that x is not equal to zero. We are going to invert both sides, so we have to restrict our set of solutions a tiny little bit for this Lambert W function stuff to work out. Inverting this leaves us with 1 over x being equal to, well, 1 over this chunk, but this is just e to the negative this power. E to the negative x times log of y over y. And this is actually way better. This is way, way better, because now if we multiply both sides by this exponent that we have up here, x and 1 over x are actually going to cancel out, okay? Also, we don't want y to be equal to 1 here, for example, just because then we would multiply both sides by a 0, okay? 1 is a solution, 1, 1, to this whole thing, but for this Lambert W approach, it doesn't work, okay? It just doesn't work right now. Just keep this in mind, okay? Lambert W works, for example, for complex solutions, okay? If you are interested, take more from alpha, put in some actual values into the end result that we are going to get, and then you are going to see that you are going to get complex solutions, for example, at some point. Now, if we multiply both sides by this exponent, we are going to get negative x over x is going to cancel out, so negative natural log of y over y being equal to, well, this chunk times e to this chunk, okay? So negative x log of y over y times e to the negative x log of y over y. And here is where Lambert W boy comes in. Finally, freaking finally, my boys and girls out there. We are going to apply it to both sides. Then we are going to get Lambert W of this chunk. It's just something, okay? You have to evaluate it numerically. Applying Lambert W. It's going to give us Lambert W of negative log of y over y being equal to, well, Lambert W has the effect that we're going to extract this very value from here. So the solution to this thing is going to be negative x times log of y over y. And now we can multiply both sides by negative y over log of y to just separate for x. Meaning the solution to this thing right here is going to be negative y over log of y times lambda w of negative log of y over y. And then we're done, mate. But buddy, that's amazing. What a weird freaking solution, but it is what it is. It works out, okay? We got some negative signs here, mate. And this is it. Those are the solutions. Maybe it's not satisfying to you because there's some weird function flying around that you can only really solve numerically except for some trivial cases. But other than that, it's a valid thing. And it's here. And it's right at your door, okay? My boys and girls out there. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like and subscribe. I'm going to do more videos like this. Maybe, for example, what happens if we take log of x plus y being equal to log of x plus log of y, okay? What is this going to evaluate to? We are going to see more false mathematics rules to come, done right. But before we end the video, I would like to thank today's sponsor, Print.org, for sponsoring yet another video on the Flammable Maths channel. So I hope you guys did enjoy this new calculus and analysis related problem that featured a very prominent special function that we have covered before on this channel. I really love working on such simple looking problems that turn out to yield such intimidating solutions. If you also find joy in playing around with algebraic expressions, logarithms, and like to simply try out new and exciting mathematical tricks, then Brilliant could be the perfect fit for you. Braille is an online learning platform and app which focuses on active learning and problem solving. Braille can help you achieve your STEM goals by working through their over 60 interactive courses in maths, computer sciences, and all sorts of scientific disciplines. A huge variety of mathematics-oriented content to play around with can be found in their amazing Mathematics Fundamentals course. Other than that, they have just recently added their brand new Linear Algebra with Applications course that I have covered with you, my subscribers, already on a very eventful livestream. So if you really want to get a first glance of their brilliant website, make sure to check out one of those livestreams. They are always such a lot of fun and I really enjoy working with you, my subscribers, through all of those problems on those courses. If this feels like it's something for you, make sure to check out the link at the top of the description. With it, you can get completely free access to Brain, and the first 200 people to use the link get 20% off an annual premium subscription. So try out Brain and support the channel this way. If you did enjoy this video, please like and subscribe and recommend channel if you like. If you want to support the channel a bit more, you know how you can do this, you know the drill, and if you want to see more videos of that sort, then make sure to share the video around such that I can make a weekly thing out of it, for example. If it gets recognized by YouTube audience, then it's worth making such videos. So don't forget to share the video, and I'm seeing you next video. Ciao, have flammable day.